Well, okay, YouTube friends, so here we go. I got that 16'6", quite a bit of taper. I got a little ATV jack, motorcycle jack under the end there. Kind of split that taper, so. I forgot the bark was dirty, so I debarked this. I kept running over all the bits of bark, so now it's just a nice board in there. As you can see, I changed my mind, and I'm glad it stayed there, but I went ahead and bumped it up and took a 2-inch slab there. Thank you.
work.
Cutting a 6-inch cant here, and that's pretty heavy. So I'm gonna put some wedge on the back side.
Unnoticed by me, the battery died at this point in the phone. My old camera quit working, so I got a new one. Should get in a couple days, I ordered, but I was just using my phone and the phone battery died. So all the more that was left here is this was 2 6-inch cants, a little over 12 inches wide, so it was a bit of a chore. I drug them both back, flipped one up, then the other up, so I just cut them both at the same time. Dropped down to 12 inches, cut 2 slabs, cut them up, got them out of the way, and then dropped down 6 inches and cut 2 6x6s, leaving 2 6x6s. So ultimately on this log, I got 4 16-foot 6x6s, 2 2x6s, and a 2x4. Out of it, and quite a bit on firewood. I could have fiddled around a little more and maybe got some 8-foot 2x4s or maybe 2x6s out of the slabs, which I guess wouldn't have been too bad. I could have always bucked part of the slab off and did it, but I'm just targeting some specific lumber on here. And you know, I don't mind having a little excess in firewood, so anyhow, that's how I did it, and that's how I dealt with this big log. It was definitely a workout. This lumber in particular, I'm wanting this longer length because I'm stockpiling this for a project that's coming up. I'm going to build a deck, basically a platform, as low to the ground as I can get, and then put the sawmill on that. That way it stays level, because I'm really battling it coming out of level, rolling these big logs up on there and stuff. It wiggles it all around. And that'll give me a nice consistent flat surface that I can then attach the feet to also, so they won't roll off. And with that, the part of the reason I want the really long lumber. Well, I guess the main reason, because you can do it with shorter otherwise, is I'm going to cover it with just like a lean-to roof. And on the front side of that, that's kind of where I came up with the 16-footer. I want a nice 16-foot opening, or 14-foot at least. It would make these really long logs a pain. I don't plan on milling a whole lot of long logs, but you can manage to get them in there at an angle. But I wanted the 6x6, so I'd maybe hang a chain hoist there to deal with some of these larger logs that aren't quite as long, you know, and then I'll need a fair amount of 10 or 12 footers. Depending on the width, I think I'll need 12 footers because it'll be about 10 foot wide, and that gives me a little overhang, and I'll probably bring cedar down a little on the front and the back of the sloped roof, as well as the front and the back of the roof to limit what blows in. But ultimately, it'll work out. Yeah, when it's real sunny, it's kind of miserable being out cooking in the sun. It'll give you some shade, or like especially now, rain, snow, sleet, give you a covered spot. Mill, it'll be a lot better for the mill as well. It won't be out in the elements. Granted, I do cover it, but you know, if we have a pouring down rainy day and I can't do much else, stage a few logs or cans or whatever, throw a raincoat on, get them up on there, take it off, mill up some lumber. Sounds good to me. So anyhow, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.